Tech Titanium here, guys, once again, and this video is in response to OKC Winning's comment regarding video memory scale and render worker counts and the effects that they have on the game in terms of performance. So we're going to go into this assuming that the video memory scale works out of a 100% system, and by default that's set to 85% in my specific case, and it's going to allocate 15% as of right now to the rest of the system applications running in the background and whatever else it has to process. So as you can see briefly, we're sitting in the 280s in terms of average FPS, and going to graphics, you guys can pause this, take a screenshot, but these are the settings that I've come up with, and I came up with these by benchmarking each of these individually to give you what you're seeing and my overall system FPS. So going back to in-game, we can see that we're hovering the 280s, and just as of last week, I was in the 260s, but just a couple of days ago, the game did update and I magically have more frames. I'm not complaining, we're going to take those, but I haven't changed any of the in-game settings. So going to the players folder, navigating over to the bottom here, we're going to go ahead and set this to 1.0, basically telling the game that it has access to 100% of that scale. So we're going to go ahead and save this and launch back into the game. Navigate to settings, graphics, because we told it to do this. It's going to set itself to the maximum, which is 90. So it's going to save 10%, like I said, for the rest of the system. Bringing up the overlay, as we can see, we're still in the 280s in terms of average FPS, and the game feels no different. It's still performing the same with the settings that I've chose. So as of right now, nothing. And we've averaged 281.6. So let's go ahead and go back to the players folder, navigating all the way down to the bottom. We're going to go ahead and set this to 0.70. which, in my opinion, in this system makes no sense, because I'm basically limiting the game to a 70% option on that scale of 100. And going over to settings, once again, it's now told the game that it has 70% to play with. And the overall estimated usage is still 5.8 gigabytes with the settings that I have selected. But in terms of FPS, it's still hovering 280. So once again, no difference in terms of feedback from the game. Still feels as smooth. And we achieved 278.2 on average on this setting. So I'm going to go ahead and set this to 1.2, which was something we were told to do back in Warzone 1. And it still hovers in the 280s, guys, but the point I'm making is, if we go back to this section, we've now told the game that it has 18 gigs to play with, when in reality, it's still a 16 gigabyte card. And if you're in a case where you have an 8 gigabyte card and the game is using pretty much next to the same amount in terms of VRAM usage, you have to dial back your settings. Changing the video memory scale isn't going to do anything when, at the end of the day, you have an 8 gigabyte card and you're using 8 gigs of VRAM. So decreasing the graphics is going to improve the smoothness of your game, because, just simply put, the system can't handle extreme or ultra settings, or even high, the way that you currently have it built. That's just the reality of it. So my conclusion to the video memory scale is just to leave it at default, as decreasing or increasing this section doesn't make a difference. Okay, guys, so let's go ahead and take a look at the graph that I've created for you guys to see the numbers on my specific PC. And to clarify, this is a 13900K paired with an RTX 4080 alongside 6400 megahertz of 32 gigabyte RAM, in a dual channel configuration, so 2x16 gigabytes with a cast latency of 32. Now, before I talk about these numbers, I had to do each benchmark 3 times for every single render worker count or thread count, whatever you want to call this, basically using the same map, starting in the same position, and of course replicating my movement best that I possibly could for a total of 48 times to get you guys these results. So it took me a whole day just to gather these numbers for you guys to see that the numbers are pretty much consistent across the board. So my worst thread count is 1, which saw a high of 253.5 FPS and 180 FPS in terms of 0.1% lows, and the default, which is 16, saw a high of 296 FPS with 214 for the 0.1% lows. Now, this is why the game is frustrating, because when I made my video last week, which I gathered the data for a week prior, I was only getting like 260 plus in terms of average FPS with the settings that I showed you in the beginning of the video. They just released, there was an update, 2 days ago? And all of a sudden, I went from, 260 to 290 on average. Extra 30 frames of doing absolutely nothing. That's the frustrating part about this game. That's why it's not optimized well, because the numbers change all the time. But in terms of the settings, I've done nothing and I'm getting more FPS. So I'm going to leave the system the way that I have it configured. So let's go ahead and jump into the game one last time. I'm just going to go back to the settings just to show you guys that regardless of setting the video memory scale to 0.70, 1.0, or 1.2, the total game estimate is 5.9 gigs. And this is what's going to impact the smoothness of your game. By dialing back your settings, if your system just simply can't handle having all the settings set to high or ultra, whatever the case may be, you got to dial it back. Because if you look at the overlay here where it says memory in the first slot, the game, it's telling me that it's currently using 5.7 gigs. And the in-game feature is telling me 5.9. So we can see these numbers fluctuate, which is perfectly fine. But at the end of the day, you just have to dial back your settings. Because if I show you minimum, it's 3.2 gigs estimated, and extreme is 6.2 gigs in terms of VRAM usage. So by changing the video memory scale, how much could it possibly do? We have to dial back those graphics to actually see a difference in terms of performance. And the last thing we're going to talk about in this video, guys, is the shader cache size. I'm just going to go ahead and open my notepad here. And if you copy this and type it into your system, it's going to bring you to the location of this NVIDIA shader cache. So I'm just going to go ahead into my search, paste, enter. We're going to go into DirectX cache, and this is where it stores all the shader information when you play the game. And if I add all that up, guys, in terms of multiplayer, I don't even hit half a gigabyte, and the driver default is set to 1 gig on my PC. And if we go over to NVIDIA control panel, you can see it's set to driver default, but you do have options in here, right? So you can set this to 10 gig, 100 gig, or unlimited if your PC, of course, is suited for that. But the point here is the way that it works is if you set this to 100 gigabytes, right, you have to play the game enough times for it to collect all the information it needs. It needs to see the data. So you gotta, just play the game, walk around the map, stuff renders in, it has to build its database, right? And this is supposed to potentially reduce the stuttering in the game. Now, for my PC specifically, the 13900K paired with the 4080, even the 3080, it stuttered like crazy. That launch week, absolute disaster. But the second they sent out the update for the game, I no longer stuttered in that plane. I didn't really notice anything compared to what we experienced that first week of that launch. So if you do decide to set this to 10 gigabytes or whatever the case may be, just keep in mind you have to play the game, build the information to see maybe a difference in terms of stuttering. And once it hits that limit, it's going to basically overwrite itself, right? Even if you have it set to unlimited, once it hits that capacity, it's going to start to store new information, because simply speaking, unless you land in the same spot of the game, you're never going to compile the same amount of information, right? The circle moves, the final circle is always in a different location. So no matter what, the game is changing, the information is changing. So what it stores is going to be different every single time. So keep that in mind depending on what option you choose here, guys. I'm going to go ahead and test the game with the settings that I have set in-game with my PC with the NVIDIA control panel settings you see, and see how it actually performs in Warzone 2.0. And those are going to be the videos that I focus on in the next coming videos. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and the information that I've given you. Have a good one as always. Thanks for watching.